Hello friends, thanks for being here in my YouTube channel. Myself Kedar Swami, I'm a Agri-Chief Culture Assistant Professor of Plant Pathology. Today we are going to see the diseases of rice. The major disease of rice and their causal organisms. Today we are going to see only the rice blast and brown spot of rice. Rice blast is caused by Pyricularia grisei, as brown spot of rice is caused by Helminthosporium oryzae. First, rice blast causal organism Pyricularia grisei. The symptoms are: the disease can infect paddy at all growth stages and all aerial part of the plants, that is leaf, neck and nodes. Among the three levels, leaves and neck infection are more severe. Small specks originate on leaves, subsequently enlarge into spindle-shaped spot with ashy center. Several spots coalesce and form big irregular patches. These are the symptoms of the rice blast, that is spindle-shaped spots having the ash colored center. It is the characteristic symptom of blast rice. Leaf blast, as we see, this disease is categorized under three parts, that is leaf blast, neck blast and nodal blast. First of all, we see the leaf blast. Severe cases of infection, entire crop give a blasted or burnt appearance, hence the name called blast. Severe cases, lodging of crop after ear emergence. Let us see the neck blast. Neck region of panicle develops a block colored and shrivels completely. Partially grain set, inhibited panicle breaks at the neck and hangs. Nodal blast, nodes become black and break up. Etiology is nothing but it is the morphological study of that pathogen, how does it looks like. So let me see about the mycelium. Mycelium is nothing but the group of the hyphae. Okay, so mycelium is septate hyaline to oliaceous. Next, the reproduction is asexual, bicurved to fusiform, four-celled hyaline ascospores produced in Parenthesia. Parenthesia, it is nothing but it is the spore fruit, where in the adverse condition of the climate, the spores can survive in this shield, that is Parenthesia. Infection. Primary source of infection, that is conidia from infected seeds and plant debris. Secondary spread of infection, that is airborne conidia. Epidemiology, the most favorable condition for sporulation, spore germination and infection of plant tissue by the blast fungicide, high relative humidity. Free moisture on the plant tissue surface and temperature around 82 degree Fahrenheit. Temperatures cooler or warmer than this slow down disease development but do not prohibit it. As the season progresses, watch out for mild temperatures, calm mornings and foggy overcast skies that favor extended free moisture period, all conditions that promote blast development. Life cycle of the fungus. Rice blight fungus starts its infection cycle when a three-celled conidium lands on the rice leaf surface. The spore attaches to the hydrophobic cuticle and germinates, producing a narrow germ tube which subsequently flattens and hooks at its tip before differentiating into an acrosorium. The single-celled acrosorium matures and the three-celled conidium collapses and dies in a programmed progress that requires autophagy. The epithelium becomes melanized and develops substantial turgor. This translates into physical force and a narrow penetration peg from at the base, puncturing the cuticle and allowing entry into the rice epidermis. Cell-to-cell movement can initially occur by plasmodesmata. Disease lesions occur between 72 and 96 hours after infection, and sporulation occurs under humid conditions. Aerial conidiophores with sympodially arrayed spores are carried to new host plants by dewdrop splash. Management. The cultural method: remove collateral weed host from bud and channels. Use only disease-free seeds. Avoid excess nitrogen. Apply nitrogen in 3 split dose, that is 50% basal, 25% in tillering phase, and 25% nitrogen in panicle initiation stage. Use resistant variety, that is CO47. Chemical method: spray after observing initial infection of the disease. Next, carbendazim, 50 wettable powder at the rate 500 gram per hectare. Next disease, that is brown spot of rice. Causal organism: Helminthospermum oryzae. It is the causal organism for the brown spot of rice. And symptoms are, these are very unique symptoms and having the characteristic symptoms, that is occurs in nursery as well as main field. Cause: blight of seedlings. Leaf spotting is very common. Isolated brown and round to oval, resembles sesame seed. Spot measures 0.5 to 2.0 millimeter in breadth. Coalesce to form large patches. Coalition means it is nothing but the merging of adjacent spot. Seeds also infected black to brown spots on glumes. Spots are covered by olivaceous velvety growth. Infection also occurs on panicle neck with brown color appearance. 50% yield reduction in severe cases. You can observe here first image the dark brown or black spots on panicle, glumes and grains. Brown spots on grains. Etiology: mycelium is inter or intracellular. Intercellular means what? The mycelium runs or grow between the two cells, and intracellular means the growth of the mycelium within the cell. Septate conidiophores emerge in groups through the epidermis or stomata. Bears conidia singly are 8 to 10 celled, tapering towards end and bulge at middle, brownish in color. Infection: primary source of infection, that is infected seeds. That's why it is recommended to use the healthy and disease-free seeds. The next, secondary spread of infection, that is collateral host. To avoid collateral host adjacent to the field. Epidemiology: the disease is prevalent throughout the rice growing tract of the world. It is found to be pandemic in heavy rainfall areas, namely Himalayas, Assam, Malabar coast and West Bengal. The disease is generally severe in soil of low pH, low available potassium, and also deficient in essential and trace elements. Temperature of 25 to 30 degrees Celsius, relative humidity, that is more than 90%. Heavy and late northeast monsoon, cloudy days, high dose of nitrogen. Look at this. These are the different stages of life cycle. Here the conidia are 6 to 12 septate, and conidia 4 is septate 1. Management: preventive measures, use of resistant varieties, namely Rashi, IR36 or Jagannath. Proper crop nutrition, avoid water stress, clean cultivation. Cultural practices, use disease-free seeds for sowing. Do not use high nitrogenous fertilizer. Use resistant variety, that is Amrut. Chemical control: it is if the disease observed in the field, then spray 1 gram of एडिफिनोफॉस और 2 ग्राम मैनकोजेब और 2.25 ग्राम जिनेब इन 1 लीटर ऑफ वाटर। थैंक यू।